If you've not taken a look at the first video of the reed finishing, I encourage you to do so. There are several concepts in here I will be assuming that you have understanding of. This video series here is going to be very essential for your understanding of the pedagogy I'm putting forth for reed finishing. You may need to refer to this video several times. And again, I encourage you to visit the IDRIS website and look up my article, or go to tworead.net, the number two for tworead, and look up the article on the pedagogy of bassoon reed finishing that I've supplied. An important part of this concept is the idea of counterpoises. And I've given here a definition of counterpoise. A counterpoise is a force or influence that balances or equally counteracts another. And you'll see in just a moment or two that I use these concepts of specialty reed types as counterpoises for the way in which you can make reeds. Here, for example, are the three reed type counterpoises. These are the three specialty reed types. We've got one counterpoise that is this high note reed. Another counterpoise is this low note slash quiet reed. And the third is this concerto loud reed. We'll see the normal reed is in the middle of this, and in fact draws on various features from all three reed types. So you might want to think of each of these specialty reeds as maybe being some sort of extreme. If we just had, for instance, two counterpoises, then we would be on a continuum. And normal might be in this area, and you travel towards high note or low note on this continuum and this idea, and you'd borrow, you know, as you got more towards low note, you'd borrow from concepts that create a low note or quiet reed. But I have, in my conception of reed making, actually three counterpoises or three reed types. And so more of this drawing more illustrates the way in which I think it'll be useful for us to think. So let's address some of these reed types. The normal reed type, that's the one that we found in the center of the different types of counterpoises. The normal reed type is the best possible compromise of the three specialty reed types. It features stable intonation, pleasing tone, great articulation, all the registers, good articulation, all the registers. Maybe not as good as some of the reed types. For instance, the high note reed may articulate better in the high register than a normal reed type. The low note reed may indeed articulate better in the low register than the normal reed type. So it's still a compromise. It should feature flexible dynamic contrasts. And as we'll see later, points of inflection, and that was a term we introduced in our last series. The specialty reed types, again featuring the three, are the high note, low note, or quiet. And I might add that this is the quiet reed type is one that I personally would use when I play continuo, where you want a very subtle playing that perhaps joins a cello or another continuo instrument. Where you're able to play very quietly, great tone, but you generally don't play much above a mezzo forte in some of these continuo parts, so you would emphasize that particular reed type. The concerto or loud reed is one that, of course, you'd play a concerto with, hence the title. Let's look at some of the features now of these three specialty reed types. The high note reed type, in general, features a narrower shape. And by shape, it could be both in the blade itself or in the throat measurements as well, the tube itself. A shorter blade, rounded first and second wires, a greater heart to wings ratio. And again, review to you the first video for where the heart was and the wings were found. Greater spine to rail ratio, points of inflection, and parallel scrape. This is again an example I introduced in the first about extreme point of view or extreme examples of the parallel scrape, where generally from about the heart area on back. We've got the same thickness to the blade, or the sloped or pyramid, where you have a sloping through most of the blade of the reed. The low note, or quiet or continual reed, features generally a wider shape, especially in the blade, longer blade, flattened first and second wires, lesser heart to wings ratio, lesser spine to rail ratio with a thinner spine. That's going to be important for us to consider as well. And a thinner tip, and often the sloping scrape seems to emphasize this type of reed just a bit more. Our third type is the concerto or loud reed. This generally has a wider shape, particularly in the throat. Features no points of inflection, or some slight inflections at the wings, and a lesser spine to rails ratio with thicker rails, actually thicker spine as well, I should have said here, and a larger aperture height and width. Now let's just further explore this concerto or loud reed. In order to play loud on the bassoon, it's a function not only of the amount of surface area you have vibrating on the reed, but also the amount of air you can blow through the reed. So for this reason, the concerto reed in general has a higher aperture height and aperture width through all of its articulation. That allows for greater airflow through the reed. And that's also the reason why the wider throat shape can also help a reed to be louder. Again, you've got the ability to put more air through the reed. Now, I've got to give the caveats here, and that is that not all specialty reed types will have every feature listed. They'll draw upon many of the characteristics as components to achieve the desired results, but it doesn't mean that all of these characteristics will be present. Think of these characteristics a bit like ingredients in a stew. More of one ingredient should be added if another ingredient is taken away or even omitted. So some of this is even sort of a recipe of playing. You might have your high note reed, and one player might find it's preferable, instead of having as narrow a blade, for instance, having a shorter blade. Now let's try to understand a little bit the relationship between points of inflection and reed types. And I've mentioned that, for instance, a concerto reed does not have these points of inflection at least as much. And you do tend to find that in the high note and often even in the low note reed. Reeds with points of inflection allow for multiple reed apertures. And this is due to the spring-like action of the reed. The spring-like action permits the performer to select varying reed apertures, as illustrated here. So you can make a choice of having a very open aperture all the way to an aperture that's very small, and everything in between here. Since the apertures change the vibrational surface, you're really almost, as it is, changing the size of the reed. That's why it's very helpful to have the smallest reed possible for the high register, and that's why the illustration here in 3, we show lesser vibration area. This whole white area would be vibrating. This would be closed off with a more embouchure pressure, as shown here in number 3. And conversely, you have a greater vibration area with a very relaxed embouchure, and only the very blackest areas here dampening vibration, where the rest of this would be vibrating for the reed. That would favor, of course, a lower register, a louder reed, and those sort of issues as well.